Hi, I'm Barbara Walters, and this is the Rosie O'Donnell Show. On today's show, Lenny Kravitz, Kyle Chandler, and me. Hit it, John.
Listen, here's the old theme song.
Barbara?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Where are you from, Barbara?
Well, I'm from Boston, but I live in New York.
Oh, you do? That's mm-hmm. great. What do you do for a living?
Play.
You play?
Play. Yeah. Different things.
Uh-huh. And how did you get to do this opening announce today?
Well, there was a wonderful auction uh-huh. that you did uh-huh. for the kids that you support.
Yeah.
And the first prize, I guess, if you bid money, yeah. was that you could host the show.
Yeah.
So I bid the money.
You bid the
and
money?
Here I am.
I'm telling you, nothing warms my heart more than when a young, unknown person gets to make their TV debut here on our show.
Do I get the job?
You did so well, I'm gonna have to let you know, because we have a lot of people, and,
somebody bid more?
A few people bid more, but you did bid a lot. And I am very thankful for that.
My pleasure.
We have a great show. Barbara Walters is here. You might want to stick around.
Nah.
All right. Say hi to John McDee, the McDee LC.
Doing great. How are you?
How funny is she that she did that?
That was so great.
She is so hysterical. She did. She bid a lot of money.
That's so cool of her.
A lot of money. And you know when you do those auctions, the lights on you, you can't really see who's bidding.
Who
it's just
is,
people,
right?
just an arm, you
yeah,
know?
Yeah.
And it was like, yeah, I think it was $70,000.
My gosh.
A lot
That's
of money
so
from Ms.
Generous.
Barbara Walters.
Really
yes,
wonderful.
It was very nice of her. She'll be here up first today on our show.
Excellent.
You like this desk?
Yes, it's very cool. I see.
It was designed by Chris Salucci.
Yep.
Who is from Philadelphia. And she's not here today, but apparently she knows a lot of people there.
That's right.
And it's her desk she designed for the Oscars.
Right.
Get it? Oscar the Grouch, Oscar Mayer, Oscar De La Hoya,
right.
Oscar De La Renta,
right.
and Oscar Madison, of course. So there you have it. It's
Indeed.
A brilliant idea.
Yeah.
For our
Very cool.
Oscars. Which is on this Sunday, which is my birthday, and tomorrow we're gonna have a little special birthday show.
That's
we're
right.
gonna have Elton John.
Yep.
All hour tomorrow.
That's
Love
good.
Him.
Yeah.
It's his birthday as well next week. It's
right,
his birthday
yeah.
on the 25th, I think.
Early
and the
week.
Borges quads are gonna be here, and it's gonna be a lot of fun.
Cool.
A lot of fun. How are you,
cool.
Johnny?
I'm good. Good. What, everything.
What'd you do last night?
I was watching the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame inductions. It was so cool on VH1. You know?
Oh yeah.
Excellent performances.
Yeah, really I
great.
Didn't
Bruce
see
Springsteen
that.
And Billy Joel, and it's really great.
Are they gonna
really
rerun great. It? They rerun a lot of things.
I hope they
there.
Do. Yeah, it was really
VH1,
great.
VH1. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I had
cool.
I had a hard night of TV.
You did.
What I happened? Had to tape Oprah on the 60 Minutes 2 while watching Party of Five.
Party of Five, right?
So I didn't want to miss either.
yeah.
Picture in picture. I couldn't have done that one as well.
Two.
Party of Five, very upsetting.
Really? What happened?
Bailey stole Owen from Charlie, pretty much.
Really?
Bailey, like, sued him, and they went to this arbitrator to get custody of Owen, which is just so wrong of him. I mean, it really had me upset. And then, thank God, Julia told off Ned and said, see ya. And I have a feeling Ned's gonna jump off a bridge. And, But it made me, did anyone cry at the end of it? Or it's just a very, very emotional week for me because that Natalie Merchant song, did they put it on here? This is what they, at the very end when like, you know, you see Charlie alone with his baby, Diana,
uh-huh.
in the house alone, and then Owen and, you know, Bailey, who I now hate, you know, and they played this song.
Oh, people downcast and dispersing. It's a little harder every day.
I'm at home like this. Bailey has hurt Charlie. You know, because Charlie, his parents got killed and he had to leave Seattle and come and raise his five siblings, and he did such a good job, and then they all turned on him for no reason. I was crying. This has been the worst week for me.
This has been a highly emotional week for you.
It is a very emotional week for me.
It has been.
Nothing has been helping. Everything
that
could go wrong went wrong.
It's true.
I had to have an extra therapy session.
Oh.
I did, and you want to know why? Because when I went to therapy the first time, which is after Audra fell off the stage Monday, I went Tuesday.
Yeah.
And all I did was cry. I had 45 minutes. I cried the whole 45 minutes.
Wow.
I had to go back yesterday to tell her why I was crying. And she kept saying, if you just breathe, maybe you can. I'm like, I can't. Loser! I'm in need of severe medication. That's the end of the story.
Oy.
And everything on TV is making me cry, hysterical. And 2020, which I watch all the time, Barbara's on. I watch it. Watching it last night, had to turn it off. Because the thing about the people who beat up their parents, elder abuse, could not watch it. Because the night before, I watched the other show where the 16-year-old kid gave birth to a baby and then...
Oh, yeah.
And they showed the baby dead in the garbage. Hysterical crying at that. It's like everything is ruining everything for me. I am just gonna watch Funny Girl from now on.
That's a good idea.
That's all I'm doing.
That'll cheer you up.
Now, something funny did happen, though.
What?
You know our writers on the staff, we've got like 6 or 7 or 8, I don't even know how many, very funny writers, and they're really good friends with each other, and it's a great kind of environment. And there's one writer, Seth Radetzky, who you see, he often plays the man in the audience who wants to do cabaret. He's very funny. He's a health food freak. And the rest of the people are really not health food freaks.
Uh-huh.
So he's always trying to get them to eat this real healthy stuff. So these are his healthy cheese doodle puffs that he brought in, like from the health food store, that really taste like cardboard nothing. They're horrible. And so Linda and the other writers were eating them going, they're horrible, Seth. And he's like, they're not. And he's seriously mad. They're not horrible. She goes, okay, here, taste one. And what Linda did, she put these styrofoam peanuts. They're blue styrofoam peanuts that people sense. She put them in the bowl with them, and he took one, and he chewed it. And he was like, they're not bad.
You are kidding.
I was hysterical laughing.
That's hilarious.
So the moral of the story is, if you're really emotional and upset, get someone to eat a styrofoam peanut.
It works.
Now to the kids at home, don't eat them. They can make you sick. Okay, a little comedy. People are very angry at you, John.
They are?
You played Scottish songs yesterday instead of Irish songs.
Did I?
Yeah, don't you ever read the computer?
I read that. They said,
he played this guy. I am Irish, and I don't think there's a descent. You know?
But you know what?
You played Scotland the Brave.
Never heard of it.
Yesterday.
Never heard of it.
You played it, though. Do you remember?
I have all my music here.
All right, you look through. Okay. Tell me when you find Scotland the Brave.
All right.
Also, Peter, who's our Irish writer who is from England, even though he's Irish.
Yes.
He apparently was having an aneurysm yesterday during the show. I can hardly believe it. He's playing a Scottish song here on St. Patrick's Day. It's horribly affected. There he is, look. See? That's him going, no! Take me off the air. Don't put me in. But did you
play? I had no idea.
Well, you check on that.
It must be called something else, too, because I have the whole thing here.
It's called Irish People Stink. What is it called?
I don't know. I'll find out from Peter.
It's called Scotland the Brave. He's the one who told me.
Okay.
And you know, want to hear a real funny thing, John?
What?
This morning, you know, a lot of people were giving me my birthday gifts at the staff today.
Oh, right.
It's my birthday Sunday.
Right.
And so they're saying, oh, this person, I checked your foundation. The check was very nice. And then they go, oh, and this is a check from John for your foundation. And it said, John McDaniel, the 4-0 Kids Foundation, $6.05. Now, I don't want to be presumptuous and think, I went, $6? $6. Not that that's not nice that you would think, but $6? And then a 5 cents, sort of like a 5 cents, you know what I mean? Like
no,
$6
wait,
and
what?
Five, you know?
No, wait, no, wait. I can,
no,
this is
it's
truly...
like when you're really mad at a waitress, you know, you leave like $1.14,
exactly.
You know what I mean?
Really piss her off.
$6, and I thought, I don't even know if I should bring this up to you, John,
that
but
is,
what was
well,
the point
no,
of that?
That is from a young man from Florida named Christopher, who sent that, he's a fan, he sent in change. He sent me some dollar bills and some change, and I kept the cash and I wrote the check. That's what happened.
Oh, well, so, you could have wrote a note.
Well, yeah, you're right, I should have. I sent it to Mary and thought, you know, I'll tell her.
A little, you know, hey, this is not from me. I don't hate you, you're not as big a loser as you are,
no,
or something like that.
Your present is coming, so.
Just keep playing that Scotland song.
Yeah, exactly.
All right. What else? That's all. We're giving stuff away today because that makes me feel better. The King and I, you know, is coming out in animation. Did you know
yeah,
this?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, on March 19th, which is soon.
Soon.
soon. It's tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Of course it is. We all know when it is. It is tomorrow. And The King and I, which I've seen it, they sent me a little videotape, and it's wonderful, of
yeah.
course, as you all know, The King and I music. They also have a CD-ROM. We're giving it to everyone in the audience today for kids age 4 to 7. Because it is the Oscars on Sunday and tomorrow's our special birthday show. This is what you get if you go to the Oscars and you sit in the bleachers to watch everybody come down the red carpet. This is what you get to sit on. It's from the people who make the Serta mattresses. It's called Sunday at the Oscars, and we're giving you one of these. And they're giving away a lot of mattresses to charity, so thank you at Serta. All right. All right, what else? Who else is here? Lenny Kravitz is here! Patootie, Kyle Chandler from Early Edition, and also Homefront, one of my favorite shows. And I can't wait to meet Bee Hackett, this woman who sent me, she sent me an invitation to, that she has kept since 1969, one of Barbara Streisand's first concert tours.
Wow.
She sent me it in the mail. She's 80, and she told me she turns 80 on my birthday.
Oh,
we
cool.
share a birthday. And she sent it to me as a gift, and we called her and we asked her to come on and talk about that Barbara
Neat.
Streisand concert. So she's here too. So don't go away. Barbara Walters is up first. We'll be right back.
You know, this might look good and it might tempt you because I used to eat them all the time. But you can go out to fast food restaurants. You just got to make better choices, such as maybe a salad and a baked potato. Or what I do now, choose grilled over fried. And you know what? Get those vegetables steamed, not sauteed. It'll make a big difference, and this won't end up.
Our first guest is well known as the celebrities and world leaders and newsmakers she interviews this Sunday night. She's hosting her annual Oscar special. Here's a peek.
I wouldn't go back to being a brunette for anything.
What made you decide to go platinum blonde?
Because it grew in that way when I, after my surgery, mm-hmm. my tumor, I've got a 7-inch scar. And it grew in platinum.
And you said, that's it.
That's what nature wants. That's what nature's gonna get.
Please welcome back to the show, the one and only Barbara Walters.
So did I get the job?
You got the job. You're it. Every day you're our opening announcer.
I can give up all those other things that I, you know, that I
have to do. Yeah, Lord knows you're not busy. You could have the time to come over and do this.
Every day.
Wouldn't that be fun?
Congratulations on your 11 Emmys.
And your 11 as well. You did very well.
I
did 10. Oh, you did 10? Same thing.
I think we're 10, and I think you're 11, and I'm proud of us both.
Well, it's a wonderful show, it is, and I enjoy watching it.
Well, we love to. You have the job. You can come on whenever you want, and you often do, unless I say words that upset you.
Okay, enough. Don't start with that again now, Barbara, please.
Wouldn't think, wouldn't say it. Don't know it.
Let me ask you right off the bat, Elizabeth Taylor, how is she? Is she well?
She is in fantastic condition. You know, do you remember when Harry met Sally?
Of course.
Okay. Do you remember there was that scene when Meg Ryan was supposedly doing something in a word I won't use with you?
Yes, okay. in
and
the restaurant.
Was, yeah, and she was getting all excited.
Yes,
and
yes.
when it was done, the lady at the other table said, whatever she's having, I want to have.
Right.
Okay. We did an interview with Elizabeth Taylor 2 years ago, and she was feeling fine. 4 days later, she went in the hospital and had the brain surgery. And she's been in a depression, and she had a fall, and everything was really very bad for her. Now, she is bouncing. She is funny. She is bawdy. She is terrific. All I want to know is, whatever she's having, I want
to
have.
You'd like to have, yeah.
I was very happy for
her.
Well,
I'm so happy, too. She's had such a hard medical history.
Yeah,
she really has.
Hard life. She's had a sad life with it all, but she's in terrific shape. How do you like the platinum hair?
I think it looks nice on her. I do. I really do. I think that when people let their hair go the natural way like that, it looks like Tyne Daly. Did you see at the benefit we were at the other night? Tyne Daly has her hair all salt and pepper, looks beautiful as well.
That was such a thing. Yeah,
yes, the event of Audra falling off the stage. Yeah, Barbara Walters was there as well, and you had to go on shortly after she was.
Well, the other Friday night, I went to a concert at Carnegie Hall, and some friends took us out to dinner, and there was a young man, and I won't say his name, but he is a reporter, and he was talking to me, and suddenly something, and I said, "Are you all right?" And he said, "I don't think so," and fainted on the floor. Mm. The night of your dinner, I'd had to go to a something for Christian Amanpour, so I got there late, and just as I got there, Audra was singing this wonderful song, and I had just walked in and saw her go, boom, are you feeling okay sitting next to me?
Yeah, I feel all right right now. It could be you.
But then all of these marvelous performers came out of love for you, and they were so good. And, of course, people were kind of clapping like this. So that's why when I came out, I said, aren't they wonderful? And I was looking at your face. You
looked
so stricken.
I could not stop crying. It was horrible. I could not stop crying. In fact, on Monday, we're having the cast of Fosse on because they followed Audra.
They did, and they were wonderful.
They were wonderful. And the whole time they were dancing, they kept looking over at me hysterical going,
yeah, and they were singing. What were they doing?
They sang a great
body, Rosie,
and
it was wonderful. And then her piano player, Audra's piano player,
who was our staff writer here,
and said, "Let me tell you, she's not seriously ill. Don't worry about
right.
it." So at least I was able to reassure you a bit.
But yeah,
it was a wonderful night.
It was a great night, and I was a wreck, but I did all right. Now let me tell you, I didn't watch the Monica interview.
Well,
was it hard to do for you, honestly? Because I heard that you asked very personal questions. I didn't watch it, but was it hard? Because it must have been.
It was difficult, and it took a very long time to arrange, what with Ken Starr's restrictions and her own lawyers and so forth. Do you know, after it, what we got the most mail about and telephone calls about, since you didn't see it? Her lipstick.
Her lipstick.
Did any of you see this interview?
Yeah, everyone saw it but me, apparently. Everyone
in
the free world.
Darling, you stayed.
You know,
I don't want
it upsets
you to hear
me.
I know it does.
It does. The whole thing upset me.
I know.
Have you heard from the White House since?
No.
I didn't think so.
The other night, I had to MC a dinner for First Ladies in Washington, and I had to introduce Mrs. Clinton.
Oy vey.
Yeah, well, I don't know whether she said oy vey, but as she gave me a handshake. It wasn't a hug and kiss.
No.
But she's always very gracious, and I was very gracious, and I'm professional, and she was doing her job, and I was doing my job, but it was a little...
Yeah. You know, did you feel a little icky about it when you saw her there? Did you, like, go, oh, no?
No, I knew she was going to be there, and I knew that she would be charming about it, and she always is. You know, you've met her, Rosie. She's always very warm and very nice, and, you know, so be it. But, it was the second, I'm sure, for each of us.
Think she's going to leave him?
Oh, that's, to me, is the most mysterious marriage I have ever seen. So, who knows?
Do you think she is?
Do you think she's going to leave?
Totally. I totally think she is.
You do?
I think it's going to be, see ya. Listen, she hasn't said anything. I think she's, right now looking at apartments in Manhattan.
And someone hears.
Soon as she's a see ya, nice to meet you. Have a good life. Open a library somewhere. Go enjoy.
What I don't understand is, she becomes more and more admirable, and I think that's fine, as she stays with him.
Well, I think people think that she is dignified.
Yeah,
and
she's handled it with grace.
She's very dignified.
Yes.
She has had an amazing amount of grace in a horrific situation. But I don't for one minute think that she's sitting at home singing Tammy Wynette, Stand By Your Man, and Oh, Isn't Life Great. I think she's a brilliant woman. She has done so much for children. And I think that she'll have a career that will far exceed him and not ruin her legacy as he ruined his own. That's what I think. Is that too hostile?
No, I mean, this is the way you feel. And yet, there was all of this business recently about that she had been very hurt by this interview. You didn't see it, but when you hear that he called Monica at least 50 times and 3-4 times a week. I mean, you have to be enormously hurt. So then there was the story that she had a bad back. The next thing we see, they're holding hands and going to church. So I don't know what, you know, good luck.
Bet you 50 bucks she leaves him. 50 bucks.
Oh, I'm betting that she won't?
Yeah.
Okay.
50 bucks?
How long do we wait?
Before he's out of office is my belief.
Before he's out of office,
I
will win.
No, here's the thing.
No. You heard it. Before he's out of office.
No, here's the thing. She's declaring, I think...
Yes?
For a woman who just gave me $70,000, you're very happy to win 50.
Well, you know, 50 here, 50 there.
It adds up. Okay. But I think she'll declare for the Senate and come here and leave him. You know, I don't know if she'll file, but they will be separate.
Before he leaves office.
Before he leaves.
Okay, I'll come back.
I wish she did it a few months back, but that's just me. Now, who else is on your special this year?
Elizabeth Taylor, Susan Sarandon, and Celine Dion.
Oh, is she delightful? She's one of the nicest. She really is.
You know what? She is. She is one of the nicest people I've ever met, and she is, I'd heard it rumored, she is leaving the business for 2 years. The last concert she will do, she told us, is in New Year's Eve, and we saw her with her husband, whom she adores, Renee. And she is leaving because she says that she thinks that working so hard has prevented her from having a baby.
Right, and she wants a baby desperately.
She's got to rest that. Mm-hmm.
Yes, and she's one of 13 children, so she comes from
14.
14. Yes, and she comes from a very big family.
Youngest of 14 children.
Yeah, she's a delightful woman. The only way people can make fun of her is to say how nice she is.
That's
right. Like, there's nothing you can pick on her about.
And you think that it's not for real, and it is. And we did it from her house in Palm Beach.
Did you bring me a clip?
I brought you a clip. I thought you were in a clip from the house. Yeah, I brought you a clip from the show.
What do you mean, of grass? You think I want a little
thing? Marble, darling.
Oh, marble. That would be a chip instead of a clip.
Yeah.
All right, so this is Celine.
This is what we've been talking about, yeah.
Okay, this is Oscar night, as you all know. Take a look.
The success and the money and everything is like much too much, and it's time for us to stop now and have a normal life.
Do you think that because you have been working, you have not been able to be pregnant?
Yes.
Do the doctors feel that
yes.
What you need is some rest?
Yes, definitely. There's nothing wrong with my health. A lot of things have been said about it,
yes.
But I'm telling you, there's nothing wrong about my health. I love what I do, but now it's time for me to take a break. If I need, this baby needs time. It needs, it probably doesn't work now because the baby's probably saying, well, you don't have time for me yet, so mm-hmm. If you have time for me, maybe I'll come and join you.
Just for the record, you're not pregnant now?
I'm not.
But she'd love to be, I think, you know? She's really a great, great person.
It is tough to just say, I'm going to walk away for 2 years. Mm-hmm. And she wants to do all the things that most people don't want to do. She doesn't want to ride in chauffeured limousine. She wants to go to the supermarket. She wants to pick out her own tomatoes. I said, most people don't want to do that. They want to do the... She wants to have a normal life. She never has.
Right.
She's been working since
she was a small child.
Yeah.
Yeah, and they have a
so
great marriage,
delightful.
Too, and he's a delightful
yes, they
man.
Do.
Well, I can't wait to see it. I never miss it.
Thank you, darling.
If you ever put Monica on, I'm not watching
okay.
it. Okay. All right, just so you know, even the Oscar special, I will not tune in.
Okay, well, I don't want to lose you. So
you don't want to lose
So me. It'll be Celine Dion, Susan Sarandon, and Elizabeth Taylor.
Good. And now, she's not co-hosting The View. You know that rumor.
No, you All know, right. We were teasing about it one
oh, okay.
day. No, she is not co-hosting The
All
View.
All right, good,
no.
because...
No, we are now down to three, and we're going to make a final decision probably end of April, early May.
Okay, the time of the special. Okay, look at them. All the producers are going, say
oh,
the time
you,
of the
you,
special.
It's a new time.
It's a new time?
Yeah.
Yes, because they're on an hour earlier, correct?
Well, they're on Sunday night.
Yes.
And you want to say it? Want me to
no,
say
you say it.
Okay.
You know.
So
Go ahead.
So we're on at 7 o'clock Eastern, 6 o'clock Central, and we follow the Academy Awards in the
LA.
West. Yes.
Excellent. I will watch it. Barbara Walters, you're a delight
thank
as always.
You,
and thank you
Rosie.
So much
thank
for
you,
doing
it.
We'll be right back. This is what she sent me, my first birthday gift in the mail. I love it. And I was going to call and say thanks, but I thought we'd just have her drop by the show and tell us in person all about this. And it's her birthday as well on the 21st. Please welcome 80-year-old Bee Hackett.
Rosie, this is my first birthday present.
It's your first birthday present?
Being here with you.
Well, Bee, I want to say.
I love you.
I can't believe you're 80. Look at you. You look fabulous.
I tried, but yeah. You look better than me.
I'm a little bit younger.
That's right. We got, I know what.
We
can
got,
I say it?
Sure, say it.
37?
I'll be 37 on Sunday, and you'll be the big 8-0.
Big 8-0. So I have, you know, can I tell you about this before?
Tell me about anything you like.
You know, I'll do that because I'm one that, you know, keeps talking like that, and because I love you. You know, I was in the business for about 58 years yeah. around show people and all, and I met a lot of people. And from time to time, you get these things and you keep it. I don't, to me, it's like it was destined for you to have this.
Yeah.
And from watching your shows, I know about your Tommy and about Streisand, and I even said, God, I had nothing from Tommy because he's much younger than us.
Sure.
If I brought you something from him, I'd probably be sitting there. I don't know. Something like that.
I even like this more because it's from 1969 yeah. right. at the International Hotel in Las Vegas.
Yeah, let me tell you about that.
Tell me about that, Bee.
First of all, I'm fond of Streisand. I had the pleasure of meeting her before going to this thing.
Yeah.
Way in the early 50s before anybody knew her. And I worked in the supper club over on the east side. A very right. snazzy supper club. Nice, you know, like Elaine's and stuff. And she came by and she looked like a hippie, but we had a piano bar.
Yeah.
And she wanted to know if she could sing a song. So she went in, she looked, the boss chased her. So
chased her out?
Chased her because she looked like a hippie. She wanted to sing.
Yeah. So those hippies, people thought they were dangerous, right?
Are you kidding?
Yeah. No,
they should only know. And I can't even tell you about these things because you're a baby. You're so...
Okay.
Yeah, so anyway, she comes by. So then I was there a couple of years as a time when I worked there about 11, 12 years.
Right.
And then when she started to become famous, I kept saying to my boss, look, Bill. Look what you missed. Look what you
look
missed.
Look who you chased out.
So then this came about. I had my best girlfriend who passed away a couple of years ago. Irish, like you, the best, Hennessy.
Hennessy?
That was my best girlfriend. And so when they opened this hotel, which is the Hilton now.
Yeah.
The International. So it wasn't quite finished. We didn't know that Barbara was going to be there. But they invited all the pit bosses. You know Vegas.
Sure.
You've probably been to Vegas. They had the pit bosses, and they had all the people that owned shops. And my girlfriend owned a very exclusive children's shop. I wish I knew now. I'd get some for Parker and Chelsea.
Yeah.
Are you kidding?
It's closed now,
the
though,
best.
Right?
Yeah, well.
Yeah, totally.
It's so many years ago, you know.
Yeah.
Well, anyway, they gave a cocktail party and a dinner party, and they invited all these people because, you know, they figured their money is going to keep the hotel going. And so she needed a partner, but I was out there, so we went as a couple.
Yeah.
She didn't go for these things, but I did. So then the waiter comes by, and he gives these menus. So I'm saying to myself, should I ask for the menu to keep it? What are they going to do with it, you know?
Yeah, what do they want? Yeah.
So he gave me the menu,
and you...
we had the dinner and all, and then with every course that you had,
yeah.
they stopped, they gave you wine because they were getting everybody drunk. They didn't know what the hell they were doing.
Yeah. And then she came out and sang?
No, not yet.
Not yet?
So then...
Yeah.
So then...
This is a good story. Go ahead.
They had everybody stop before yeah. the dessert.
Uh-huh.
No service and all. And after her appearance, they would have the dessert and the after-dinner drinks, aperitifs and whatever. So now, they go, da-da-da-da, ladies and gentlemen, the International
proudly presents,
you know, like all the other, Miss Barbara Streisand. Out she comes, Rosie,
yeah.
in a white terry robe, with a, well, if you ever talk to her, she remembers that, with a white turban towel all around her head. And so a lot of, some of them were snickering,
yeah.
and some were applauding. Well, this was her opening, which was great. Well, she said, ladies and gentlemen, she said the hotel was not finished, so I thought I could get away with it and come out like that. And then there's a thunderous applause.
Right.
So I had this. Now, I watch you all the time. I'm not saying it because I don't. I do.
I believe you. You knew the whole Tommy thing.
I think you're the... You know how you know the songs and the names?
Yeah.
You'll ask me about your back shows and about old song numbers.
You know them.
You and I could do a duet.
All right.
Anyway, so I said to myself... When I saw the Borgia quads,
yeah.
you had them?
Yeah.
That's when you learned about the birthday.
That's right.
About the 21st, when I saw that show. And then I said, I'm going to be 80 now. I said, what am I going to do with this? I remembered having it and how you felt about
Barbara.
About Barbara.
And so you sent it to me.
And so I figured, I'm gonna send you this.
Let me tell you, Bee, this is my best birthday gift this year. What do you want for your
God,
birthday?
Can I kiss you?
No, what do you want for your birthday? Tell me first, what do you want?
I'll tell you in 1 minute, I gotta do
No,
one...
you gotta tell me first, because we're already over.
Oh!
That was the longest story we ever had, Bee, but it was good. It was good, but it was long.
That was great.
You tell me...
I want to say hello to my sister in a nursing home in South Carolina. I want you to wave
How
to her.
How old is your sister?
93.
93 years old.
I haven't seen her in 9 years.
In 9 years.
That
well, guess what you're doing for
friend.
Your birthday? We're flying you there. We're putting you up at a hotel. We'll get you a car service to and from you to see your sister.
Rosie, if I kiss you...
You can kiss me. I kiss you back. Happy birthday, Bee.
And you're the healthiest.
Thank you very much
more than
for that.
80.
I hope.
And there's nothing I can do for... And I spoke to the other barber, you know.
You did?
Because I worked at her father's club in the Latin Quarter.
Yeah.
So I said hello to
we'll
her.
We'll show them. That picture. Look at there's Bee when she worked at the Latin Quarter. Barbara Walters, father of... Lenny Kravitz up next. Happy birthday. Look what we have for you. Cutie Patootie, Kyle Chandler. It's been 3 years since our next guest recorded a CD, but when he did, he won a Grammy, and critics hail it as his best work yet. The CD is 5. Here he is, Lenny Kravitz.
Thank you very much.
Was that exciting for you?
Yes.
But you didn't go to the event, did you?
No, I wasn't there.
You weren't there?
I was in Paris, and I was driving out in a car. About 3 a.m, my daughter called me. And she said, Daddy, you won. I was getting ready to get into, like, really? Tell me about it. She's like, I gotta go. I'm hanging out with Brandy and Monica. And
oh, really?
Lauren. You know, I have to go. Click. And I was like, oh, okay.
How old is your daughter now?
10.
And you were, she recorded this, she was with you when you recorded the record down in the
Most of it, yeah.
Yeah. That must be fun for her to get to watch Dad work.
Yeah, she, you know, comes in and tells me how to do it.
Right. You all know Lenny's mom was on The Jeffersons. Roxy, I loved her so much. She was
Thank
so great.
Much.
She really was. And you have a charity that you want to tell everyone about, Kids 2000?
Yeah, it's called Kids 2000, and it's an organization that I'm trying to, you know, bring the awareness of child abuse to the public more. You know, 4 children die a day, child abuse, and it's a horrible thing. So we're putting on a concert in Miami in April of 2000, and we hope you all will be there.
And I will definitely be there, I'll tell you that. I have a house
Thank
there,
you.
And I love it there.
All
it's right. great to see you.
Thank you.
Lenny Kravitz, 5 is the CD. We'll be right back after this. Sitting home, safe in our houses on Saturday night. Our next guest is rescuing people from burning buildings, plane crashes, and speeding bullets on TV anyway. He's the star of the hit show Early Edition. Take a look.
Easy now. Just take it easy. Go slow. I'm going to talk to you. Don't look down. You look right at me. You hear me? Come on. You're doing great. Come on. Slow. Come on. Come on. Sorry. You look right at me. That's it. Come on. You look right at me.
God, the anxiety I have from this. Please welcome Cutie Patootie, Kyle Chandler.
Hello.
You look so cute in that shirt,
Thank you.
So springy and nice.
I thought I'd bring a little bit of spring to New York. You notice the temperatures are nice today.
It's a beautiful day. It certainly is.
And it's got little baseball players all over. I got it in San Diego, so I thought I'd choose it. My daughter decided that it was a good one, so
You know,
here
and you
is.
Played a baseball player on Homefront, so
I
it all ties work. In.
It all works. It's
yes.
a big circle of life.
How is your daughter?
She's doing great.
Is she good?
She's very good. As a matter of fact, I have a question to ask you.
Go ahead.
My daughter... I brought you a little picture. One time you asked me, you said, bring a little picture of it. This is one that I took with, I'm an amateur photographer. I'm really bad, actually, but this one I got lucky on.
Oh, wow,
that's
that
my
is
daughter.
Beautiful. Wow, what a gorgeous girl. Look at that.
Now.
And that's a very good picture, Kyle. You could have, like, a whole other career.
I was very lucky with that one. You should see the rest are thumbs and fingers.
Oh, really?
But now my daughter has a little dog that when my wife and I were pregnant, we got a, well, when my wife was pregnant.
No, that's so sweet to say that, because it is true.
We got a little stuffed animal for Sydney, and
right.
it was a little dog. And since then, we can't find another dog. And you know, if your child has one particular thing, like 2 blankies, one in the dryer, washer, one in the kid's hands.
Exactly.
If you lose one, you're dead. And we've actually left it on a plane once. I had to run back to the plane, search the plane, only to find out it was in a backpack. So if your audience could help me find, if anyone ever sees this dog,
Wow.
And can write in to the Rosie Show or CBS and let us know where we can find one, I certainly would appreciate it.
It sort of looks like a Snoopy dog, but it's all brown.
It's brown. It's brown. His name is Mavis.
Mavis.
A.K.A. Baby Dog.
Which is the company that makes it? Is the tag
I don't know.
Still
no,
on?
No, the tag's been worn away years ago, along with his tongue. See, his tongue's disappearing.
His tongue's going away, too.
He's got problems.
You know that our staff told us that you had this problem.
Yes.
We didn't find it. We tried to find it. We could not find this dog for you. We searched high and low for like a week.
Sorry, Sid.
But you know what we did get you?
What?
We got you a dog collar with low jack.
Oh, yeah!
We did.
All right!
So
Woo.
You put this on the animal, and then they'll satellite track it. We paid. They think it's a car. They'll be tracking this like it's a car. So if it's ever missing, you call low jack and say, someone stole my car, they'll find your dog. So there
That's
you go.
Great.
That works.
Low jack.
Well, my son has that with a thermal shirt that I had from The Gap. Like, it's very worn out. It's sort of... It was a black shirt, but it's almost a steel gray.
Right.
And I can't get another shirt the same color because it's 4 years old, and he sleeps with it. It's the mommy shirt.
Right.
I tried to fake another mommy shirt?
No.
No way.
No, it
hysterics.
Doesn't.
My mommy shirt is missing. My mommy shirt. I don't know what you do about that. It's a lot of stress.
That's like when the goldfish dies and you get a new goldfish.
Yeah.
No one else could ever tell the goldfish, but the kid wakes up first thing in the morning. It's not my goldfish.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
Oh, honey, this is what happened now. The toilet. Oh, no.
We're going to take a commercial. Come back with Kyle. Don't go away. We'll be right back. Kyle Chandler, early edition is on Saturdays. I watch it every week while I'm playing Scrabble because I'm home always.
I have weekends, me too.
Yeah. How's the show going? It's a great show.
Thank you. The show's going great. This year's been so much fun. This particular episode they showed the clip of, if you watch the show, Gary goes out and, of course, he saves the day. And you're almost assured Gary's going to somehow save the day. And they try to make it smart I may do something that actually saves the day,
right,
but I don't know I did it.
Exactly.
So the domino effect, if you will. Well, this episode, I don't save the guy.
You don't?
Now, you'll see what happens to this guy. It's a pretty brutal, graphic deal for early edition.
Yeah. Then, well, thanks for warning me, because I've been emotional all week, and
it's not
bad.
That brutal.
Oh,
you can watch it. Kids can still watch.
Yeah. But you don't save him, and it throws you, I bet, into a tizzy.
Well, that happens in the beginning of the show, and then later on in the show, I find my own obituary. And so the show's called Fate, and it goes further into sort of introducing where the paper comes from, the gentleman that had the paper before me. And it's a really good episode, and for me it's great because it changes, it gives me a chance now to change the character to a different area. It's
right.
A little bit deeper for my character, so it's going to be a lot of fun.
Well, it really is a great show, and everybody should watch it on Saturday nights if you're home. What do you got for me there?
I've got these we handed out to our crew on early edition. This year, and
the wrap gift sweatshirt.
Right, and I brought that for your charity.
You'll sign it for us.
It is signed down there.
Oh,
and it's got a number 3 for third year.
Well, I thank you very, very much.
You're very welcome.
Continued success to you, and give your baby girl a kiss.
Thanks.
We'll be right back. Don't go away, Kyle Chandler. Oh, we're on. Lenny Kravitz gave us this amazing Fender Stratocaster, and he signed it, and we're putting it on eBay.com. And Lenny, I want to thank you very, very much. His tour starts April 23rd in Los Angeles. Tomorrow is our birthday show with Elton John. And I'd just like to leave you with playing a little Lenny Kravitz here on the Fender. This is all me. I'm not lip syncing. So